Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I will show you the unboxing and the assembly of a 3D printer. My brother bought one and I had the pleasure to unbox it and assemble it. It's a Anycubic Kobra NEO printer. They sell it around 200 euro right now. The printer has a printing volume of 220 millimeters by 220 millimeters and 250 millimeters height. So let's say about this size. If I ever buy a printer, then it will definitely be a larger scale. But I am surprised how well this printer works. In the background, you can hear some fan noise. That is actually the printer running right now. I mean, we are using it now since a week, and today I'm posting the video of how I assembled it and how, yeah, the unboxing and the assembly. I hope you like the video, I hope I explain it well, and I hope you don't make the same mistakes like I did in the video when you get the printer by yourself. So enjoy the video and let me know in the comments below if video is okay like this, or if you would like me to explain it better. So let's see first what comes in the box. So there is a small assembly instruction, then some 10 meters of test filament, then a lot of caution, the x-axis and the c-axis, already pre-assembled, more filler, that's for the filament holder. Power plug, tool, a USB stick, the screws, and Allen keys, and some other tools for the assembly. I assume this is for the filament holder. The monitor and the ground part, the main part of the machine. So that is all from the box. So then let's start with the assembly. This is the front facing me. Gently drop the head here and let's see what it says. So it says here I have to pull the screws from under. So let's see how we do that the easiest way. This one goes like this. So just bring it here to the front. So let's start. This one comes like this. You can see here the prefabricated place where it goes. Then on the outside, one long bolt. One here on the outside.
So let me drop it on the side a little bit for now. So you see, I put the long screw here. The shorter one goes under here in the prefabricated hole. Surprisingly long. Then same on the other side. Let's see next. I assume this one comes here, but these two longer bolts, because the other one will be too short. So it says these screws have been locked. So unlock them. So now the problem, the mistake I made is I have to bring this out first. Let's see, anything else? Nope, that was it. So now I can assemble it back. It was just a stupid mistake from my side without looking first, starting to assemble. But yeah, that's me. I usually don't read instructions. And sometimes that costs a little time. I'm glad that nothing got damaged, but costs a little bit time. And since we just have this view here, I can as well plug in the screen. We remove this tiny screw here, because that is going to hold here. And that's the limit switch for the computer to know when we reached the end of set axis. And in. Mount it. Here this cable is for the stepping motor of the set of the X axis, X, Y, and up and down is set. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 holes. Good. Then the next thing is to tight this here, and therefore we have to go completely to this side to make sure that we have enough way. So here we are, the complete up. You can see here is spring loaded that nothing gets damaged. Then you just open this, put it around the wire or hose you want to clamp, put it in place. Now we drive the print head completely to this direction. Here we have enough, you can see that. We even give it a little bit more so that there's no pull on these wires. And then to fix the end, you just put this in, put the lid on it, and it's fixed. Doesn't have to hold much, it's just the empty roller which is then hanging here. So last but not least, we have to connect the stepping motor for the set axle. Then this stepping motor here. Then we still have the limit switch for the Y and the limit switch for the C, for the up and down. So all wires are connected, everything moves freely. This one is magnetically fixed here. As you can see, this is all one big natural magnet. This is actually a steel plate, so put it like this, and the assembly is done.
I hope I explained it well enough how to assemble the printer. And directly after the assembly, I did my first test print, which I will show in another video. Some of the prints will come. I will make a video how I design something in Creo parametrics, then I use CUDA to slice it and then show you how the printer does it. Also, look out for some shorts from me. I will drop shorts how I print some of my projects. And yeah, I hope you enjoy such videos. Let me know in the comments below and enjoy the rest of your day. Have fun. Bye bye.